myself. My name is Anastasia Tajudin. I'm a student magister of Mathematics Education, Universitas 11 Maret. And now I'm presenting my article with the title Development of Module Based on Realistic Mathematics Education to Improve Critical Thinking Skill of High School Age Students. Introduction. Indonesian Ministerial Regulation No. 22 of 2006 concerning content standards of for elementary and secondary education unit states that mathematics needs to be given to all students starting from elementary school to equip students with logically analytical, systematic, critical, and creative thinking skill, as well as the ability to work together. This shows that mathematics learning doesn't only refer to student learning outcomes, but also to the ability to think logically, analytically, systematically, critically, and creatively, as well as the ability to work together. And then critical thinking skill of junior high school students in Indonesia are still low. This is evident from research conducted by Dian Kurniati, Romi Harimukti, and Nur Asiyah Jamil at 2016 that 12 students from 30 junior high school students spread across Jember who have completed PISA question are not able to perform analytical evaluation, creative logic and reasoning skill with good in solving my problem, so it is classified as having high level thinking skill. We have low levels. It is necessary to apply learning modules, especially in mathematics lesson, by providing treatment and emphasis on higher order thinking skill in accordance with the 2013 curriculum. Higher order thinking skill that require critical, creative, analytical thinking to information and data in solving problems by Barrett 2014. One of the higher order thinking skill that is emphasized is the ability to think critically. Research method. This article was written using the literature study method with content analysis techniques from scientific articles and other references in the form of relevant print and electronic media. Findings and discussion. Modules. Modules are teaching materials that are systematically arranged so that user can learn independently with or without a teacher. According to Darianto, the module has the following characteristics. First, self-instructional, which allows students to learn independently and not depend on others. 2. Self-contained, all learning materials are contained in the module. 3. Standalone, not dependent on another media or in conjunction with other media. 4. Adaptive, has a high adaptability to the development of science and technology, and is flexible to use anywhere. 5. User-friendly, familiar with wearer. And then realistic mathematics education. Realistic mathematics education is an approach in learning mathematics in the Netherlands in 1970 by Hans Vergenta. While the learning approach is the way that teacher that in the implementation of learning so that the concept presented can adapt to student. Gofer and Dock 2000 explained that realistic mathematics education was developed based on three principles, namely a guided reinvention through progressive mathematization. Through the topics presented, students must be given the opportunity to experience the same process as mathematical concepts were found. B. Didactical phenomenology. The mathematical topics presented are contextual problems that will be arise in learning must consider two things, namely their application or benefits and their contribution to the development of further mathematical concepts. C. Self-developed models. The role of self-developed models is a bridge for students from real situation to concrete situation, or from informal mathematics to formal mathematics. This means that students make their own models in solving problems. The first is a model of a situation that is close to the student's nature. With generalization and formalization of the model will be turned into a model of the problem. The model of will shift to a model for similar problem. In the end will be knowledge in formal mathematics. And then critical thinking skills. Perkin in Agent and Kauchak at 2012 states that critical thinking is the ability to collect, interpret, and evaluate information accurately and efficiently. According to Robert Stenberg in Elliott et al. At 1999, critical thinking consists of processes, strategies, and mental representations that people use to solve problems, make decisions, and learn new concepts. Thus, thinking is an important process that occurs in learning, because without thinking or thinking about what a person learns will not gain understanding and knowledge about what he is learning. And it's in his 1.20.18, page 9, explained that critical thinking is a process that aims to make reasonable decisions about something to believe and do, and it also describes the basic elements of critical thinking, namely free scope, focus, presence, inference, situation, clarity, and overview. The following is Ennis' explanation of free scope. 1. Focus is to pay attention to or describe situation, equation, problems, or important things. 2. Reason is an effort to get good enough ideas based on reasonable considerate. 3. Inference is to give considerate consideration to whether the reason are reasonable, can support the conclusion, acceptable, and how strong. 4. Situation is a situation that involves people, goods, history, knowledge, emotion, and desires or interests. When thinking is focused on beliefs and decision, displays a significant situation and provides some rules and or condition. 5. Clarity is a state that can be understood easily and there is no confusion. For example, in writing or speaking. 6. Overview is a thorough examination what has been discovered, decided, considered, studied, and concluded. Research result. Based on the result of research conducted by Okta Asmara Yuda et al. In 2019, showed that there was an increase in students' mathematical problem-solving abilities in comparative material between those who receive learning use the MEA model with realistic mathematics education approach rather than direct learning models for class 8 MTS 1 Singkawang 2018 or 2019 students. And 2. The next, in a study conducted by Fahmi Rizki Hanaisullah et al. In 2021, it showed that from the literature studied through the stages review of the identifying, refining, evaluating, and interpreting existing research, several indicators of student mathematical critical thinking abilities could be developed, namely interpreting, analyzing, evaluating, and drawing conclusion. And the last, well, research conducted by Delina et al. In 2018, based on the result of calculation and hypothesis testing, it was concluded that there was an increase in mathematical critical thinking skills and self-confidence of class 7 students at SMP 1 Plerup who received a realistic mathematical education approach better than those who received ordinary learning. Conclusion. Based on the result of the analysis and discussion, it can be concluded that the DRMA approach is an innovative and fun approach. The characteristic of realistic mathematics education or RME prioritizes realistic relationships and condition to eliminate learning habits that are less meaningful. Realistic mathematics education approach can improve mathematics learning outcomes and improve students' critical thinking skill. Realistic mathematics education approach provides guidance for teachers to make students active subjects of learning. So, RME approach is suggested to be applied by teacher in making mathematics modules. That's all. Thank you for your attention and see you next time.